boys deserve equal protection under the law, right?
We don't have it yet.
It's the most sensitive parts of the penis we like. That's what's wrong with
circumcision. I got my sensitive penis parts.
You get 100% of the experience.
100%.
Foreskin! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the front lawn of the BC Parliament Buildings. And I'm your host and MC for today's protest speeches, protesting a new circumcision clinic here in Victoria. Now, I'm here today because I love my foreskin.
Me too! Yeah. Me too!
And so are the guys behind me. We all love our foreskins. Why do we love our foreskins?
Because it feels great!
It feels good!
Well, okay, we're on the front lawn of the ledge here, so we'll refrain from excessive anatomical detail. But suffice to say that the foreskin is an extremely enjoyable part of the penis, and we're all very glad to have ours, right?
All right. The human rights of children in our city are being violated by two physicians who are choosing to disregard the direct guidance of the College of Physicians and Surgeons of British Columbia under the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms and the United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights. An infant has rights that include security of person, life, freedom, and bodily integrity.
Yeah.
Routine infant male circumcision is an unnecessary and irreversible procedure. This procedure should be delayed to a later date when the child can make his own informed decision.
Yeah. 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 Thank you, Kira.
Alrighty. Okay, now we have a special guest from the United States speaking next. This is Dr. George Denniston, founder of the Doctors Opposing Circumcision in the United States. Here he is.
This doctor who lives in Vancouver has opened a clinic here in Victoria to recruit unwitting infants, totally innocent infants, to remove half of the skin of their normal penis. And we oppose that completely.
Why circumcision happens. It is not for the benefit of the child. It is for the benefit of the person performing it. Dr. Pollock has performed over 35,000 circumcisions, charging about $300 per circumcision. Do the math. How much money has he earned?
Too much.
And each foreskin can be worth over $100,000 in valuable pharmaceutical products. If you have used a beauty cream that contains elastin, it is made with human foreskin tissue. Right, so everything is based on profit. Now, I want to emphasize that everyone here who is protesting today did so at their own expense. Yes. We paid our own way here. Everyone who is pro-circumcision has an interest in the profit that they make from it, entirely based on myths and false information. For example, I am a doctor of epidemiology. I look at the statistics, the experiments allegedly done in Africa. They claim a 60% reduction in HIV infection rate. The actual number is 1.37% within the bounds of experimental error. In other words, they're lying to you.
Yeah.
And yet this 60% will be trumpeted over and over again in order to get innocent parents to circumcise their helpless infants. Don't be sucked in by the falsehood. Now, these are the facts. Which is the Western country that has the highest circumcision rate in the world?
USA!
USA!
Which is the country that has the highest HIV rate in the Western world?
USA!
Circumcision is not only damaging to male sexual function, but also to female sexual response. This is what the circumcision industry never tells you. So we are here to clear up the discrepancies, to tell the truth about circumcision so that a whole generation of young Canadians can grow up proudly intact.
All right, thank you, Paul. All right, everybody. This is really the bottom line. In Canada, We have a charter of rights and freedoms that guarantees every citizen equal protection under the law. Our Canadian Criminal Code protects the foreskins of girls from any kind of cutting or amputation until they are 18 years old. And it is wonderful that our country does protect the foreskins of girls, because in some countries, they cut off the foreskins of girls, and that is wrong. Yeah. The bottom line is that if a girl has a human right to keep her foreskin and her genitals intact, a boy also has a human right to keep his foreskin and his genitals intact. That is basic human rights and basic equality that we're talking about here. Every child in this country and around the world has a fundamental right to keep all of their sex organs and not be tampered with. Thank you very much for coming out. It's been wonderful being here. And now we're going to close with the Foreskin Pride Salute. Here we go.
Foreskin Pride!
Foreskin! Foreskin!